Today, LC1 chairpersons who were elected on July 10, 2018, have made 5 years in office, marking the end of their 5-year mandate provided by the Constitution. According to senior counsel Yusuf Nsibambi, the Maokota South legislator, the outgoing chairpersons can't keep in office legally beyond today unless the Local Government Act is amended.
I think what should have been done by government is to bring a bill before Parliament to amend if there was a crisis to finance elections. However, the Constitution and the Local Government Act is very clear on the mandate of LCs and the term of office. So if it has expired, cannot be renewed unilaterally by an individual.
As the term ends today, there is no one to take over following failure by the Electoral Commission to organize fresh elections. MPs have posed several legal questions on what is going to happen after today, wondering the effect it's going to put on the communities. Local council ones act as a first magistrate court, first line of defense and security, and oversee several transactions in communities.
The over 70,000 LC ones, the over 10,000 LC twos doing their work, all together above 80,000. They do their work patriotically.
It will cause a bit of instability. They are the first at the front line of fighting crime in their areas. They are in the front line. They provide the magistrates' court in their areas. They do a lot of work.
Lawmakers are concerned on what will befall the Power Rich Development Model Program in absence of LC1 and LC2s, yet they both sit on the Power Rich Development Model Committees, which select groups and individuals to benefit from PDM activities and oversee the implementation, monitoring and evaluation of the projects at village level.
The tendency is going to affect even the performance of the government policy, more so the parish development model, PDM, because it constitutes also of the councils for women, which women councils have expired. Their term has ended, but they constitute the PDM parish model committees. So they are also sitting on committees illegally.
The government of Uganda accepted hold those elections. And even now it has come already, and we are going to face the same challenge.
The Electoral Commission requested for 90.6 billion shillings to carry out elections of LC1s and LC2 chairpersons and women council elections in July 2023. But the Minister of Finance only provided them with 36.15 billion shillings that couldn't enable the EC to move an inch. Now some lawmakers have vowed to pile pressure on government to find a supplementary budget to fund these crucial polls.
Amidst the financial crisis, where the government brings supplementary budgets, so even for this cause, if at all the government wished to do so, would have come up with supplementary budgets, and the parliament passes it in order to facilitate the re-election of the local councils.
However, some legislators have implored government to seek authority from parliament to extend the current mandate of LCs by at least 1 year as government finds money to have elections in place.
Legal catch. We should be able to also understand that these patriots can be extended, maybe through a presidential instruction or anything like that.
Meanwhile, the Parliamentary Committee of Local Government and Public Service, chaired by Martin Ojara Mapenduzi, has summoned the Minister of Local Government to forge a way forward.
We need to make sure, as I explained, those structures are very key in driving service delivery. So we want to have discussions with the Minister of Local Government. But at the end of the day, the Electoral Commission needs to organize elections so that the office bearers stay in office legally.
LC1 elections join the Women Council elections, which were meant to take place last year but didn't happen due to inadequate funding. Before organizing LC1 and LC2 elections, Uganda had spent 17 years without these elections until the law was amended to provide for voting by lining up. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.